Now I can look at the stuff as it's happening. Okay. Welcome. I'll show you guys this process. Looks nice. Okay. Thought for a second I was hearing something buzzing in the background. Okay. Welcome. Without fail, I need to wipe my glasses. So now I'm looking at bright lights and they're dirty. I don't know what to work on today, but I will figure something out. Starting things off, just gonna try drawing some stuff. See if that takes me anywhere. Maybe I combine the things I was sort of drawing most recently. Where the path, yesterday I worked on a figure that had elongated arms that were on something of a grid. That had right angles. I can grab that and look at it. Yesterday ended up with this guy, or this woman rather, this figure. But it has these grid shape, or these right angles that Hello. Pardon my mace. And four, I've been working on, I don't want to get it out of, I have a different folder for stuff from the day before, but working on faces that were built on this grid. And so maybe what I do today is I work on figures, expand and sort of Hello. Hi. And have figures that start to fill out a space. And so it's not just the heads. But on this grid. I think I might try that. So I'm going to get a piece of tracing paper. I am recording. Some tape. Start into seeing how this might look. It takes a little bit more planning, perhaps. Or I don't know. I might be able to get away with having things be improvisational. Don't know if this will work well with having the figures be. I think we're gonna have to make some decisions, but I like the idea of it being on a grid. So let's start with having a little bit looser, not quite as blocky as I typically go. I still have a solid nose. It's still going on this grid. That I made before. That's just a 1-inch grid. Having these figures some sort of. This might take a different sort of planning. Instead, occupy this space a little bit. This takes on a little. Hello, Sarah. This takes on a little bit more of like a. Aztec Incan sort of vibe to it by having these harsher angles. Today, Elizabeth Liz. I'm messing with trying to have full figures. So yesterday ended up messing with this, where it's a female figure that's looking at her palm, and there's an eye there, and then an eye in this palm. And it started out a lot smaller, where it was just the figure presented in the space, and there were it's still an abstracted figure, but not as extremely. And the eye-hand relationship is a little bit different. But I took this figure and I extended the elements and made it a little bit more rigid, a little bit more geometric. And so I'm trying today the idea of having, where before I've done just individual faces against this grid, seeing what it looks like to have figures placed against that grid, not dissimilar to this figure, but having additional ones in the mix and having a little bit more planned out of a format to it. Right now, how this figure is looking, it takes on some more Central American elements. It makes me think of Aztec and Incan designs where it's filling out. I'm sorry, I can't read Cyrillic alphabet. So I'm gonna lean out of frame for a second because I had some celery and it was stuck in my teeth. Okay. About filling out geometric space with a face that gets a little bit thicker or chunkier at times. Like these hands in particular look sort of Central American to me, and there's a lot of geometric elements in some of those. And I'm not any sort of scholar on Mexican or Aztec artwork, but it has some elements that when I actually work on this, that seem to be not terribly dissimilar. So I'm also just sort of figuring out how to fill out the space as full as possible for working on a geometric thing, but using body elements that might not have, that can't be as easily pushed one way or the other, for filling out a square space. And so I'm testing that and seeing how it goes. And whether or not I should push or pull elements or leave things like this solid, or if that should be an additional thing where it's 50% of this width of this grid. It's harder to see this grid through this tracing paper on the camera, but these are just a 1-inch grid. So, like when it comes to this foot, since this foot would be conceivably further forward, should this foot hit here, or should I play with the restrictive format being what it is, and have this meet this edge here, or should it be left to have some sort of relationship or intersection with some elements from a different figure? I think for now, since it's how I treated the hands, I'll plan on having it fill out the space, maybe with a little bit more of a gap. from the line to its side, because I'm realizing if I follow these lines exactly, then I won't have any sort of gap between the figures, but can still mess with the idea of multiple faces or stuff like that, just how it then relates to additional geometric elements. So what I'm thinking of for this space is having this figure's arm go up and over here, but just have one of the arms doing that, in which case it'll end here. And I might have this gap be only half of the width of this square, which might mean having a face or some element push a little further there. Let's zoom in a little bit. Thanks for watching. See you later, Elizabeth. Hello, Peeb. Becca? You're Becca. You're not Pib or whatever. I'm gonna take a moment to have a snack. That's the most abstracted figure, and I like that one. Okay. Today is 10/2/20. It's almost like playing a game of Snake. Cool. Okay, so next step is scanning, and then I will fill this in. It's all in frame. Should be. Scan time. Slowly scan. Oh no, I gotta change the location of those files so it's not paying attention. Designs folder 10-02-2020. This will rename it to figure grid. And let's change out this guy. This one. Scale it down while you can't see it. Then pop it into view. So now I'm going to fill this in. I'll have an image or a device capture running right now, so I'm just gonna fill this in quickly and show the result. That's not filling it in. Should be like 170. Darken this a little bit more so it's just black. Now we're in business. In the spot where it breaks. That was it. That was it. That's interesting. Okay, let me save this. Filled. And switch this out. So you can see the physical bit. And switch. That's my trademark. Making that noise. Okay. Now I messed with that, learned a bit. Something I might take time to get a bit better at elements of, or learn or push some things here and there. But that's, I guess, it for today. If anybody has questions, concerns, give you a minute on that, and then we'll get everything up. Thank you. And let you have a possibility to get it on a shirt or not if you don't want to. But thank you all for watching. I'll again give it a minute to see if there's any responses, questions, concerns, etc. But there you go. See how accurate this is position wise. It's pretty good. Okay, I'm gonna sign off. Thanks for watching. I'll be back tomorrow.